People always say that music changes the world, but does it really? What do most people think, and what makes music the way it is?
My name is Bruce Nelson. Really don't have a job. I play music and I do fun things like that. I guess I do have a little music story yet, but I'm not there much of the time, so that probably doesn't count anymore. I think you might call me retired.
Hi, I'm Sonny van der Putte. I'm a 32-year-old professional singer from Belgium.
I'm David Hilber. One of the things I do is I am a co-owner and operator of the golf course you see in the background, Lighted Greens. I'm also an optometrist, a father, a husband, son, brother.
I'm Nancy Hilber. I live in Lyda Township.
Well, my name's Katie Baker. I teach English up north. And I also coach speech, and I also am in a band, and music's kind of a huge part of my life.
My name is Jean Cairo. I'm from Bradenton, Florida.
My name is Lori Fickner-Pock, and I currently teach at 6th through 12th vocal music, Pelican Rapids High School. And I teach to about 225 students.
Edison Research has released a survey to quantify just how much Americans are listening to music. According to their Share of Ears study, most U.S. residents listen to roughly 4 hours and 5 minutes of audio each day.
Music has come to identify me in a way, but it also has connected me with so many people, my community, friends. It has taught me and shown me emotion, like happiness, calmness, brought me joy. It has brought my dad in his later months of Alzheimer's peace and joy. It's just it's in everyone's life, and I just feel that it's in and through me all the time. It's a part of me.
I'm so interested in music because it is an enigma in which I and a lot of people just love to indulge in. It's kind of like this piece of pure magic of which we know and we understand how it works, but that doesn't make it any less magical.
I'm interested in music because there's no other way that I can get these feelings that I get when I play music. There's no other way I get these feelings. I know that sounds really weird, but a lot of people would agree, I think, if you play that instrument that you love so much, or you sing that song that you love so much, or even if it's a brand new song and you're singing it for the first time and you're like, oh, that sounds really amazing. You get those butterflies. They're not really butterflies, they're like birds. They're bigger than butterflies. They're amazing. And just the ability to share those feelings with other people. That's why I do music. Gotta keep it alive to keep those connections running and that network running and those feelings and those vibes going.
It brings people together and it allows us to communicate in a completely different way. I had more than one occasion in which I met three other guys, for instance, at a convention, a barbershop convention, for instance. We didn't know each other, but we just started singing and it felt like a familiar thing. We were best friends for that brief moment in time. I can't explain it. It's bigger than all of us.
Where I thrive. hope you trust can. I try to serve by forcing out such anger that's bleeding inside. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, there's always something in the way from me to you. Always something.
A link then between music and memory. But why, when we hear a particular song, do we feel strong emotions rather than just being able to recite the lyrics? There are different kinds of memory, including explicit and implicit memory. Explicit memory is a deliberate, conscious retrieval of the past, often posed by questions like, where was I that summer? Implicit memory is more of a reactive, unintentional form of memory. A large part of memory takes place in the unconscious mind. Robert Schneider, a composer and chair of the sound program at the Art Institute of Chicago, says, there are aspects of memory that is remembered implicitly, that is, outside of consciousness. What's more, he says, implicit memory systems involve different parts of the brain than explicit memory systems. It is the explicit memory systems that are damaged by conditions like Alzheimer's disease. Implicit systems are robust in comparison. Schneider explains that things can affect us from the outside of consciousness are often regarded as powerful. In other words, implicit memory is emotional as well as durable. Music evokes emotion, but the sound and feeling of it, while important, don't necessarily define your feelings. A sad song could be associated with a happy time, and a happy one with a sad one.
I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me as long as you wanted, and then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? Wondering, what in the world should I do? I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy for crying, and crazy for trying, and I'm crazy for loving you. I'm crazy for crying, and crazy for trying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
So, what do we know about the psychology of musical preferences? There are two radically opposed views about this. One is that song preferences are completely random. The other, that our musical choices reflect important aspects of our personality.
Today's music is all about auto-tuning and perfection, and it's either do or die. And it's a shame because I feel like all the soul and all the emotions you put into a song as a singer kind of get converted to something cold and clammy through autotune. I don't need to hear a perfect performance. I need to feel it. I need to be moved. I like hearing an out-of-tune note every once in a while, just because it's real, you know? It's secondary. I need to be persuaded. I need to feel it. And if you're doing a super emotional song and your note gets kind of shaky, that just adds to it. I don't need perfection. Of course, hitting the note every once in a while is nice. But what makes a performance great? It's not being super skillful. I mean, yeah, it can be, but I don't want... You can be a perfect singer and have perfect technique and hit the notes dead on and be very skillful, but it'll make me say, wow, that was a fantastic demonstration of how you need to sing perfectly. But it doesn't make for a great performance, for a mind-blowing performance.
You know, it's hard for me to say in a like a school sense what makes a song good, because I'd be hard-pressed to tell you I like songs that are this way or that way. It's kind of like what the Supreme Court trying to say what pornography is or something. I know if it's a good song if I like it. Good for me. I mean, I have plenty of songs that I think are amazing that I know other people absolutely hate or don't see any value in, but I know it when I hear it. It might be a melody, it might be a beat, it might be the way they sing. And moving into performance part, I'd say that's a big part of it. If you're listening to a performance, I think it's the passion with which it's done, because you don't have to necessarily be the best player or the best singer, but if you're doing it with a lot of passion, and it's not to say, you know, if you're singing terribly or playing terribly, that's an obvious problem, but if it's done with a lot of passion, it can really come across as a great performance.
My fondest musical memory is by far from my wedding ceremony. My wife and I, we plan our ceremony ourselves. It was very informal, just a small group of friends and family over. And what we did was we had selected just like 4 or 5 people that would come up and they could do whatever they wanted. We didn't want to know in advance. It had to be a surprise for us as well. If they wanted to recite a poem, say a few words, show a video, whatever. And one of the people that I chose was my very first band. So it was actually 4 people because we were a 5-piece band, but of course I wasn't included. So we had those guys up and they're very creative. So I was already excited about what they were going to do. I feared that they were going to embarrass me and talk about the time that we performed a gig and I was dressed in a Santa suit and I fell off stage and tore my pants, you know, really give it to me. But they didn't. All they did was they just said very few words. They just said how I inspired them to be better musicians and better people. Even talking about it right now makes me emotional. But that was it. Just a few words. And they formed a line and they started singing a barbershop arrangement of Sonny Boy.
Climb upon my knee, Sonny Boy, Sonny Boy, you are only 3. Sonny Boy, you've no way of knowing, there's no way of showing what you mean to me, Sonny Boy. Where there are gray skies, I don't mind the gray skies. You make them blue, sunny boy, sunny boy. Friends may forsake me, let them all forsake me. You pull me through, sunny boy, sunny boy. You're sent from heaven and I know your worth. You made a heaven for me. Right here on earth, when I'm old and gray, dear, promise you won't stray, dear, I love you so. Sunny boy, sunny boy, you're sent from heaven and I know your worth, and you made a heaven for me right here on earth. For the angels grew lonely, took you 'cause they're lonely. Now I'm lonely too, sunny boy. I miss my boy, my sunny.
So beautiful, because those guys can't sing. I mean, they can hold a note, but they can't sing, and they just, the hours of rehearsal that must have gone into that was just tremendous. That was such a beautiful moment. It was so beautiful. And they totally screw up the ending of the song, which made us all burst into laughter, but I didn't know what to do. I was smiling from ear to ear and fighting back the tears all in the same time. So that was beautiful. I will never forget that. That was beautiful.
Oh yeah, music can make a huge difference. I teach junior high. One of the only ways to get my challenging students to participate in anything is to connect it with some music. And it always works. My favorite is if we're reading something, it doesn't even matter what it is. We could be reading something about changing a tire, and I could be like, okay, now it's time to song search. Go find a song that relates to this article we just read about changing a tire. And all you gotta do is find that song, tell me three reasons why it connects with what we just read, whatever it is that we just read. And they will come up with the craziest awesome stuff. They'll be like, that cymbal in the background or that drum, you hear it? That sounds just like screwing on a bolt or something like that. Or they'll be like, that crunch in the background that you hear, they'll talk about the instruments and how they mimic the sounds of changing a tire. Or they'll talk about some of the specific words, like maybe in the article it said that I'm drawing a blank now. You could get a hydraulic machine. I'm forgetting what it's called right now, but it takes off the bolts like really wicked fast. So maybe the word hydraulic is in the song that they've used. And they're like, that's connection. It's used the same word. And that's really cool. It totally motivates them. And I mean, who's going to disagree with that? Music motivates everyone. You're in a crummy mood? A lot of times music is the fix. So yeah, it can make a huge difference. Individually, in groups, in a classroom, in therapy, anywhere. Like, it definitely makes a difference.
Well, I mean, all you got to think is with a group of people at a meeting or a party or something, you put the wrong song on and it's a dud. But you put the right thing on and it brings everything to a whole different level and a binding of the group. You can see it in film with soundtracks. You get the right soundtrack, and it really just makes the story or whatever it is you're watching so much better and more memorable.
Yes, music can make a difference. Musical performances bring communities together. Singers and performers express themselves. Audiences are the recipients of the musical emotion expressed, the artistry expressed. And musical artistry helps us think deeper and differently. Music is entertainment. Music is international. We share international and cultural differences or similarities when we through music. It's a common language among the world people. It brings us together. Music makes people healthier. It brings about calmness and joy. Musical performance is one of the few activities, like I said, that uses 90% of the brain due to multiple senses and emotions being used and while performing. Your sense of touch through your vocal folds being used and coordinated are being used. Your hearing is used. Your visual sense of seeing the beat, seeing the music, and then of course emotion. So taste and smell are not used when you perform it, but the rest is, and that's why 90% of your brain is being used.
We have people that are good and people that are not so good, it's all part of the music setup or the music situation.
I'm a very good harmonizer.
Keep on listening, keep on playing, keep on singing for them and for me and for those around them.
Music is always going to be with you, and it's in your dental office, it's in the malls, it's everywhere you go, it's in your car. You're going to enjoy it your whole life, and keep enjoying it because it's a fun thing and it can be very therapeutic. Stay involved, keep going, because keep going to concerts and participating. It's a lifelong activity that you can enjoy your whole entire life. I have community choir members that are in their 80s still singing, and they love it, and soloing, by the way, in church choir. So. And I know the same goes for community bands. They still continue, older people continue to perform in community band until their 90s even. So keep at it, enjoy it, have fun your whole life with music.
So music always has a deep part inside of each of us. Even if we don't think about it on a daily basis, you're walking down the street, you hear a song playing, it can make your day that quickly. Or you're driving down the road and your favorite song comes on the radio. What emotions do you feel? It can stimulate us to the point that we don't even really know what's happening. And these emotions are some of the most powerful things that music can do.